We are in Vaniyambadi, which was in the earlier North Arcot region and now of course Vellore district of Tamil Nadu. And what brings us here to Vaniyambadi? Well, Ahmedia Hotel, a hotel that's been around here for the last 40 years and a hotel that's hugely popular with the locals and travelers who pass through Vaniyambadi. We told that this restaurant is famous for its biryani and some great mutton dishes. So let's go in and check out what a meal at Ahmedia Hotel is all about. So Zeeshan is the son of the person who started.
Yeah. Ahmedia is famous for its biryani itself. Not only Ahmedia, Vaniyambadi is famous for biryani itself. It's like not but just masala and all. It's like little bit authentic biryani is Vaniyambadi.
So kya khasiyat hai is biryani? What is
biryani
special?
Special is that it's basmati rice biryani.
Basmati rice. No jeera samba. So we will go into the kitchen and take a look at the Vaniyambadi biryani right here at Ahmedia Hotel. कितना किलो है इसमें
मटन 9 kg राइस 12 kg मटन
तो ये द यूज हियर इज कॉल्ड द पोटला अपेरेंटली द गोल्ड इज 8 to 10 kg तो दैट्स व्हाई इट इज लाइट पिंकिश सॉर्ट ऑफ अ कलर एंड ही सेज दैट्स द रीजन व्हाई इट कुक्स वेल एंड इट मेल्ट्स इन योर माउथ सो दिस इज द लॉन्ग ग्रेन बासमती राइस दैट इज यूज्ड हियर एट Ahmedia I mean, and that's very unique yeah. because most of the restaurants in Tamil Nadu use the jeera samba rice, which is a short grain.
Yeah.
But out here in Vaniyambadi, Zeeshan tells me customers prefer the long grain basmati rice, which is what I guess also makes it very aromatic.
Yeah.
So I'm told there is already a 12 o'clock deg of mutton biryani that's already ready. And this one is getting prepared for patrons who visit at 2 p.m. और ये चिकन का बन रहा
है
1 o'clock का चिकन सर बिरयानी आपका यहाँ टाइम स्लॉट में बनता है यू कैन सी दे मेक लॉन्ग ग्रेन राइस बिरयानी हियर ये क्या जा रहा है
घी का साथ स्पेशल इंग्रेडिएंट्स मिला के इसमें करते हैं हाँ
घी के साथ स्पेशल इंग्रेडिएंट्स एंड आई कैन स्मेल दिस बिरयानी स्मेल्स डिलीशियस एंड दिस इज अ चिकन बिरयानी माइंड यू आई बिलीव दैट अ मटन बिरयानी ऑलवेज हैज मोर फ्लेवर So I can see some mint and green chili that's gone into the rice water here. That gives it a bit of flavor. So this is the paki akni style of biryani where the meat is cooked separately, the rice is cooked separately. And once the rice is cooked, it's added to the akni which is the meat and then kept on dum. So the rice stays on top, you spread it out nicely and then you've got some rice starch that is poured on top. It will also help the rice cook a little more, so it'll keep it moist too. So 20 minutes this deg will be opened, there'll be some ghee and some spices that will put on top just before it's ready to serve. So there is some rasam here too. So after the biryani, after you've eaten a full plate of biryani or two, some rasam to help settle in the stomach. So there's some lovely grain masala happening. So ye kya pepper ka hai?
Ye pura pepper hai. Iska masala alega tha. Onion, takali.
So apparently this is their pepper mix, which also has some of their secret ingredients. So look at these gravies. So these are the gravies that go complimentary with the parotta. Quail ka gravy. Oh, that's a quail here.
Ye kade phal bolte
hai. Kade phal.
Pepper gravy.
Ah. Good phal bolte hai. No gas.
Gas in.
So apparently everything here at Ahmedia Hotel is made on wood fire. You can see all the biryani, everything is cooked on wooden fire. Those are tamarind logs. Tamarind logs, they retain the heat for a longer duration. So having watched all this biryani being cooked, I can't wait to get to the table and taste some of this mutton biryani. Let's go. So when we came in, this was empty. But it's lunchtime now and every table is taken. That I think speaks for the popularity of Ahmedia Hotel in the area. I believe that when you go to a restaurant and if you have the locals out there, if you have the locals flocking there, I think that speaks volumes of the reputation of the restaurant.
Teetar Pepper Dry.
That's the Quail Pepper Dry.
Kebab.
Chicken Kebab.
Mutton Bheja Fry.
The Mutton Bheja Fry. Mutton Chukka. Chicken Dry. Mutton Biryani. Quail Pepper. Then of course the Vanjaram, which is a fish, a staple fish fry in this region. I am told that I should start with the Biryani. You can see it's so hot that it stained the banana leaf here. As I was telling, we had to wait a bit for this biryani, wait for it to be cooked. But then as they say, all good things come to those who wait. So let's taste this mutton biryani that we've heard so much about and see what it's like. This is certainly an aromatic biryani. It's a very unusual biryani for the region and the rice that is used. So typically you have the short grain rice that is used in most of the biryanis that I've eaten in Tamil Nadu. But here they use the long grain basmati rice. And you can see that every strand, every grain of rice is separate. It's not sticking together. That's the hallmark of a great biryani. Very delicate in its flavor. You can taste the flavor of the meat, of the mild spices in the biryani. Look at this pink piece of meat. It looks moist and succulent. You can taste the pure flavor of the meat. There's none of that cloying spice or heavy spices weighing down on the meat. You can taste the meat. You can taste the meat in all its glory. This is a delicious biryani. So I'm told this is a bit of the masala that they put on top just as they finish the biryani. As I was saying, I'd heard about this place. I didn't know what to expect, but tasting this biryani, lovely. I got a piece of the fat right there. I can taste its savory saltiness. Beautiful. I can taste its creamy, buttery, melt in the mouth sort of texture. Just tasting this biryani has made this trip to Vaniyambadi so worthwhile. Next, I think I'm going to taste the Beja pepper fry. So you can ask for the pepper fry with the onion or without the onion. I've chosen to have the pepper fry with the onion. I think otherwise, to me personally, flavor of the brain gets a little too much, a little too intense. Let's taste that with some parota right here. You can certainly taste the peppery notes of the Beja pepper fry. It's a pepper fry, what do you expect? But then you also have the added dimension of the flavor from the curry leaf, the tartness of the tomato, and its texture. It's almost cooked to a mousse-like consistency. Some Beja with the biryani rice. It transforms the biryani rice entirely. You know, from being a light, mellow biryani, the biryani now tastes almost buttery, Beja being mixed into it. Delicious. I'm going to taste the mutton chukka next. The meat is roasted nicely. I can actually taste the flavor of the meat. You can see that the meat is seared perfectly. It's kind of seared brown, a deep brown on the outside, and it's moist and pink inside. There's a bit of the cartilage, two in the chukka, gives it that nice bite. Perfect. I'm going to taste some of the chicken chukka now with some crisp curry leaves on top. I'm going to take the bits of the curry leaf because I think it's always a tough act for the chicken to follow a mutton preparation. I love these crisped curry leaves that do well to coat the chicken and give it that intense burst of flavor. Excellent dish for a chicken lover. I'm going to taste the chicken kebab. I must say I'm not a big fan of chicken kebab because usually I find it quite dry. I think it's a piece of chicken breast. So when you cook it, when you deep fry it, it tends to dry out the bird. Not bad, but I preferred the chicken chukka to the chicken kebab. But if you love your chicken kebab, a perfectly good chicken kebab to have as well. I think next we're going to go for the vanjaram, the fish. Squeeze a bit of lime on the fish. From all the dishes that I've tasted here thus far, to me the vanjaram didn't really make the cut. I'm very particular about my fish. It wasn't the finest of specimens. And secondly, I could taste all the masala on the top. But as I bite into the fish, the masala loses its strength. So as you chew on it, it's beginning to taste a bit bland. The quail pepper fry. This is cooked perfectly. I love the crisped curry leaves on top. I think that gives it that intense burst of flavor. I think that's a nice touch. Almost blackened curry leaves. There's another great dish here. And last but not the least, I have to taste some quail masala or the quail phal. Yeah, you can see this thick gravy. You know that the quail has been braising in this gravy for a bit. And you know it's going to have soaked all the flavor, all the masala from the gravy. This is delicious. Flavor of the meat. You can taste the flavor of the masala that soaked into the meat. All that you need is a piece of parota to mop up all that goodness. It's also got that slightly tart flavor. Perhaps there is a bit of tamarind that's also used in this. I rarely go back for seconds unless it's extremely compelling. Is certainly worth going back for a second and a third and a fourth. I love this. So if you're driving in this region and you're going from Krishnagiri towards Ambur, towards Vellore or towards Chennai, getting to Vaniyambadi and Ahmedia Hotel is a bit of a detour. But most of the dishes that I've tasted here, especially the mutton biryani, the mutton chukka, the mutton brain pepper fry and the exceptional quail dishes, are certainly worth the detour. So the next time you're on the highway here, I would strongly urge you to make that detour to Vaniyambadi and have a meal at Ahmedia Hotel. It is certainly worth that pit stop. As for me, I'm going to go back to my mutton biryani that I began my meal here with. So until the next episode of Gourmet on the Road, happy eating. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to share and leave a comment. Do subscribe and stay tuned to Food Lovers TV for more episodes from Gourmet on the Road.